Good morning. Welcome to CATEX TV. My name is Frank Fortunato. Today is Tuesday, April 9th, 2013. With the passing of Margaret Thatcher, the former British Prime Minister, Lloyds has indicated that it has no plans to ring the Lutine Bell to mark her passing. Lutine Bell is a 250-year-old bell rescued from a ship that sits in the central atrium at Lloyds. Traditionally, the bell has been sounded once for bad news and twice for good news. It tolled on the deaths of Winston Churchill and President John Kennedy after his assassination. However, in recent times, the only individuals honored by the ringing of the bell have been royalty or those with clear links to the insurance sector. It was rung after the July 2005 London terror bombings, as well as the 2001 September 11th bombings in the United States. Japan has deployed Patriot missiles in Tokyo, two batteries right in front of the defense ministry, as it readies itself to defend 30 million people who live in the Tokyo metropolitan area. Local reports said that additional Patriot batteries would be deployed in another two locations in the greater Tokyo area. Tokyo's response to North Korea's threat so far has been relatively low-key. However, they are going ahead installing the anti-missile systems in Okinawa as well as in Tokyo. North Korea, meanwhile, is warning that nuclear war is imminent. In Bermuda yesterday, government officials made a big deal, and appropriately so, over the arrival of a Delta Airlines Boeing 737, which began regular service from New York's LaGuardia Airport to Bermuda nonstop. This is big news. Bermuda is now served by all three New York airports, and the LaGuardia Airport is much more convenient for people getting into and out of Manhattan. The Italian insurer Generali has narrowed to two the number of prospective bidders for the company's U.S. reinsurance unit. Reuters is reporting that now. Apparently one company is the French reinsurer SCOR. The other company has not been named yet. United Airlines said last night that it plans to begin to fly the Boeing 787 Dreamliner for the first time on May 31st. The FAA has not approved that the plane is airworthy yet, despite the test that Boeing performed last week. However, United is planning on running it domestically on May 31st on a route from Denver to Houston. It also plans on June 10th to begin to run it from Denver to Tokyo. Hopefully the FAA will comply with that. Here's an interesting one. Evidence gathered in the investigation of a fatal medical helicopter crash has raised questions about whether the pilot was distracted by personal text messages when he failed to refuel the helicopter before taking off. The August 26, 2011 accident near Mosby, Missouri killed four people, including the pilot. It's the first fatal commercial aircraft accident investigated by the National Transportation Safety Board in which texting might have been implicated. The 35-year-old pilot exchanged 20 text messages with an acquaintance over a span of less than 2 hours before the helicopter crashed into a farm over a mile from where he hoped to refuel. At least three of the messages were sent and five received while the helicopter was in flight. The timeline indicates that the pilot exchanged text messages at the same time he was reporting by radio to a company communication center that the helicopter was low on fuel. Although the pilot was not texting at the time of impact, the NTSB said that it's possible that the messaging took his mind off his duties, interrupted his chain of thought, and caused him to skip safety steps. A professor of cognitive and neural science at the University of Utah said, "People just have a limited ability to pay attention." Well, that's big news. Much of the oil that spilled into the Gulf of Mexico after the 2010 Macondo deepwater oil spill was digested by a massive explosion in oil-eating microorganisms. This is according to a presentation made yesterday at the American Chemical Society conference in New Orleans. Further research has found that there was a tenfold increase in several types of bacteria that eat oil molecules. Over time, the makeup of those bacteria changed to those that were eating different toxic chemical compounds left behind after the oil was eaten by the first round of bacteria. This is very interesting, actually, because it was corroborated by a similar study done on a BP oil spill in Uganda, in which the microorganisms had eaten most of the oil as well. Well, the leader of al-Qaeda in Iraq says that it has effectuated a merger with Syria's extremist Jabhat al-Nusra, which has been siding with the rebels fighting President Assad's regime in Syria. The leader of the Islamic State of Iraq says that the two groups will rally under the same al-Qaeda flag. It's going to be known as the Islamic State of Iraq and Syria. The development is likely to cause concerns among foreign backers of Syria's opposition. No kidding. That's the news for today. If we have any breaking news, we'll come back and tell you. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you.